week, Myanmar government gave 8 new media groups the permission to start publishing daily newspaper starting from April the 1st, bringing the total of the licenses up to 16. This is seen as a milestone in bringing the freedom of the press level up of Myanmar after decades of restrictions by the military. From Myanmar Focus Daily, we will explore media industry of Myanmar from the past, the present and the future.
In 1836, a British official, E.A. Blundell, published the country's first English-language newspaper, the Monmouth Chronicle. In 1842, the Morning Star, the first ethnic-language newspaper, was established. The support of first Burmese-language newspaper was the Christian's Dharmat Dinsa, or the Religious Herald, in 1843. 1903, Reuters News Agency opened an office in Rangoon. Burma was once regarded as the country with the freest press in Asia. The first constitution in 1947 allowed the citizens to express their opinions. When the coup took place in 1962, journalists were arrested and publications were shut down by the military. Press scrutiny boards were set up by General Ne Win's Revolutionary Council to scrutinize all materials before publication or sometimes after publication. The military formed its news agency in 1963 to control news information in and out of the country. Foreign journalists were forbidden. Only Burmese citizens were allowed to be correspondents for foreign news agencies and had to be approved by authorities. In 1964, the press of freedom in Burma had supposedly ended. By 1988, the number of newspapers had decreased from 30 to 8. The media gradually became the monopoly of the military junta under General Ne Win.
Now let's take a look at the media landscape of Myanmar from 1988 to 2010. Everything back then was tightly controlled by the military. Reporting positively about anyone who is against the military or the government was nearly impossible.
During the military rule till before the reform period, media in Myanmar is mostly state-owned, both the broadcast and print. For print, there were 4 state-owned newspapers that were allowed to publish daily. 3 of them were in Burmese and 1 was in English. Around 19 other newspapers or journals were privately owned and were not permitted to publish daily. All types of publication had to be censored by the Press Scrutiny and Registration Division, which was a reformed version of Press Scrutiny Board set up in General Ne Win's rule. The same as print, the government controlled TV stations. Major TV stations were MTV1, MTV2, MTV International, MTV3, MTV4, MRTV, MRTV3, or Myanmar International in English, MRTV4, and TV Myeongdi. As of 2011, there were around 8 FM broadcasters mostly focused on entertainment, sports, and foreign news. Apart from media inside the country, there was exile media such as Democratic Voice of Burma, which is based in Norway, Irrawaddy magazine and website, and Mizima. These media speak out for dissident communities and activists who lived abroad. There are also a BBC Burmese service, VOA Burmese, Radio Free Asia. Some of these websites were inaccessible before the 2010 general election.
For the next episode of Myanmar Focus Daily, we will take a look at the changes in the media industry of Myanmar from 2010 general election until now. Audrey Thai Mi Sang from Myanmar Focus Daily.